Operation and demonstration of PF gamma intramedullary nail system. Step 1. Position of the patient. Place the patient on the therapeutic traction bed in the supine position and monitor the surgery with a fluoroscopy. Step 2. Reduction of fracture. Perform reduction of fracture, and when satisfied, rotate the injured limb internally by 10 to 15 degrees or more, then adduct by 10 to 15 degrees, and finally, fix on traction bed. Step 3. Determine the length and diameter of the nail. Place a PF pin in front of the firma, with the proximal side at the pin entrance point and the distal side at the expected position. Then predict the length. The diameter of the selected pin should be 1.0 to 1.5 mm smaller than the reamer diameter. Step 4. Approaching and determine a pin entrance point. Cut horizontally from greater trochanter vertex to proximal side by 5 to 6 cm. Determine the pin entrance point correctly, which in lateral position is at the junction of the anterior 1/3 and posterior 2/3 of the greater trochanter vertex. Normal position is located in the apex of greater trochanter. Step 5. Open the cavity and rim. Open the bone marrow cavity along the pin entrance point with appropriate strength, using countersink awl. Insert the ball guide pin along the bottom of the countersink awl till the ball reaching the expected depth. Remove other devices except for the ball guide pin. Insert the softer reamer along the hog guide pin to rim. Reaming starts at 5-9 mm and increases gradually. After reaming started, place the softer reamer shutter. Use FI 15 mm softer reamer at first when reamed approximately, and then use FI 16 mm softer reamer. Remove softer reamer and left the ball guide pin unremoved when proximal reaming finished. Step 6. Placement of the pin. Fix the prepared PF gamma intramedullary pin onto the holder with the connection screw rod and tighten it with the connection screw wrench. Insert the ball guide pin and gently swing the holder for the insertion. If no key entrance is needed, install driver extractor connector onto the holder and connect the driver extractor. Insert the pin by slightly knocking the slider hammer. Remove the knocking devices and the ball guide pin. Step 7. Proximal locking. Install the proximal rod onto the holder and fix it. Insert C-tools, leg screw combination sleeve, into the proximal rod leg screw hole till it reaches the soft tissue of the skin, and then made 1.0 cm incision right under. Insert the leg screw combination sleeve until it reaches the bone cortex. Remove the leg screw guide pin and drill into the FI 2.8 guide pin. Monitor the placement with a fluoroscopy. When the position is correct, remove the leg screw inner sleeve. Measure the actual length that the FI 2.8 guide pin had inserted into the bone with the leg screw guide depth gauge. Drilling the leg screw hollow drill along the FI 2.8 guide pin. After the drill, install an PF leg screw with appropriate length using a leg screw loader and screw into along the thigh 2.8 guide pin. Remove the thigh 2.8 guide pin and check the placement with a fluoroscopy. If installation of lucky end caps were needed while using a leg screw loader, the direction of the indicating block of anti-rotating groove should be noted. If pressurizing is needed, rotate the pressing block clockwisely. In order to improve the stability, an anti-rotation screw could be installed. The specific operations are as follows. Insert D tools into the hole of the anti-rotation screw on the proximal rod and cut a 0.5 cm incision right under. And then insert into the anti-rotation screw combination sleeve until it reaches bone cortex. Remove the anti-rotation screw positioning pin and drill in the thigh 2.0 guide pin. Check the position and remove the anti-rotation screw inner sleeve. Measure the actual length, the thigh 2.0 guide pin, and insert it into the bone with an anti-rotation screw guide depth gauge. Remove the thigh 2.0 guide pin and drill into the limited place with anti-rotation screw limit drill. Insert anti-rotation screw with appropriate length with an anti-rotation screw loader and screw the anti-rotation screw into. After checking with a fluoroscopy, remove the non-implanted devices at the proximal side and keep the holder and connecting screw rod unremoved. Step 8. Distal locking. Install the distal static guide rod 180220 onto the holder and fix it. Insert E-tools. Full thread locking screw combination sleeve into the locking nail hole most distal until it reaches the soft tissue of the skin. Make an incision about 0.5 cm right under the continue to insert it until it reaches the bone cortex. Remove the full thread locking screw guide pin and drill in thigh 4.0 pin. When a small pit showed up on the bone surface, drill with the thigh 4.0 drill bit. When the thigh 4.0 drill bit had drilled through the first layer of the bone cortex and reaches anterolateral medullary cavity inner wall, adjust the distance between the bone spike and the full thread locking screw inner sleeve to about 1.0 cm to protect the soft tissue of contralateral skin. Then continue drilling until contralateral bone cortex is drilled through. Keep the full thread locking screw outer sleeve close to the bone cortex and insert the full thread locking screw depth gauge to measure the diameter of the bone. Choose the 5 4.5 full thread locking screw with appropriate length and screw it into with the 3.5 hexagonal screwdriver, but don't tighten it too tight. After checking the position with the fluoroscopy, place the second locking screw according to the same operation. Step 9. Placement of end cap. Remove all the non-implanted devices and adduct the patient's femur. Install appropriate normal end caps on the leg screw loader and screw it into the counter clockwisely at first, and then clockwisely along the bottom of the nail, but not too tight. If only leg screw was installed on the proximal side, the end cap should be locked when placed. Remove the PF gamma intramedullary pin system. Connect and fix with leg screw loader and PF leg screw. Pull it out. Pull out the anti-rotation screw with anti-rotation screw loader. Distal Fay 4.5 full thread locking screw could be removed with 3.5 hexagonal screwdriver and keep one of the Fay 4.5 full thread locking screw. Remove the end caps with end cap wrench and install nail removing rod at the end of the nail and screw it tight. Remove the last of Fay 4.5 full thread locking screw. Install driver extractor at the end of the nail removing rod and remove the PF nail. Distal locking method 2. Operation and demonstration of dynamic locking. Install the distal dynamic guide rod 180 to 240 onto the holder and fix it. Insert E-tools. Full thread locking screw combination sleeve into the locking nail hole most distal until it reaches the soft tissue of the skin. Made an incision about 0.5 cm right under the continue to insert it until it reaches the bone cortex. Remove the full thread locking screw guide pin and drilling Fay 4.0 pin. When a small pit showed up on the bone surface, drill with the Fay 4.0 drill bit. When the Fay 4.0 drill bit had drilled through the first layer of the bone cortex and reaches contralateral medullary cavity inner wall, adjust the distance between the bone spike and the full thread locking screw inner sleeve to about 1.0 cm to protect the soft tissue of contralateral skin. Then continue drilling until contralateral bone cortex is drilled through. Keep the full thread locking screw outer sleeve close to the bone cortex and insert the full thread locking screw depth gauge to measure the diameter of the bone. Choose the Fay 4.5 full thread locking screw with appropriate length and screw it into with the 3.5 hexagonal screwdriver, but don't tighten it too tight. After checking the position with the fluoroscopy, distal locking is over. Remaining operations are same with static locking scheme. Thank you.